Not on? Yes, there it is.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to John Philip Sousa Band Hall here at Marine Barracks, Washington, D.C. I'm so excited to welcome you here in person and also those watching online for this very special event today. My name is Colonel Jason Fettig. I am the director of the President's Own, and it is my great honor to welcome you to this edition of our Concerto Competition for High School Musicians. This is a program that we have been running for 15 years now. And over those 15 years, we have met so many incredible young artists who have traveled from all over the country to take part in this competition. So many of them have played solos with the Marine Band and have moved on to wonderful careers in music, and it's just been such a joy to watch them as their lives and their life with music has continued. We have a tremendous collection of young artists for you today. Seven fantastic musicians from seven different states from all over our nation, and we're very excited to hear them perform today and compete for this opportunity to play with the band and to win a scholarship from the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation. The only way that we could do this competition the way that it has been for the last 15 years is with the generous support of the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation. This is an incredible institution that is dedicated to telling the Marine Corps story, to lifting up Marine Corps institutions and our history all across the nation. They have been a wonderful partner with the Marine Band for so many years, helping to support a lot of our special programs just like this one, and they have been there since the very beginning of this incredible competition. We are very honored to have the President and the CEO of the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation, Major General retired James Lukeman and Mrs. Lukeman. Major General, thank you so much for being here, sir. It's wonderful to see you. And you're going to hear a little bit more from the General later on after we finished listening to these musicians. And we also have the Commanding Officer of Historic Marine Barracks, Washington here, Colonel Rob Sutcher. Rob, thank you so much for being here as well. I'm going to have a number of thank yous, and I'm also going to introduce our distinguished judging panel after we hear these players. But let's get right to the music. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy this wonderful recital. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Every year I sit back at the judges' table and I come to the realization that I never played anywhere near that well when I was in high school. It is such an impressive thing to listen to these young musicians perform. We clearly have our work cut out for us. So the judges are going to retire back to a room back here. I welcome you to please enjoy some refreshments in the lobby while we deliberate, and we'll be back with you shortly. Thank you so much. Thank you.
takes for these?
Oh, about 15 minutes, I think.
Oh, really?
Okay, that's a solid part.
flooding on the west front. But all of those things that my kids have to do when they were little, the next generation isn't going to get to do it. Sadly. Just that we used to be able to walk over there on and walk around the terrace to the west front. When I used to work with Capitol Police Roswell, my boss there said, it's coming, they're going to have to pay for it. So that's really bad. That's what we want to get from the 15
year olds. Yeah,
yeah. Unbelievable to have that kind of censorship at that age.
Oh, yeah.
I have a good friend who's not quite as close to the guy who Leo's from the partner, and they have bigger subscribers every year, probably 10 years now, and they support them through. But they have very good friends. It's just that now I'm getting to the point where I don't go out at night anymore. I don't want a rival.
I know.
Unless, you know, I've got a rival or go by Uber both ways. We just don't want to go out to Uber on our own. Unless it's on that road. Good morning. But there's lots of music on Capitol Hill.
Oh, sure.
In St. Mark's, especially the Folger and St. Mark's and Marine Barracks and all of the service bands that play every week in the summer. We're really lucky. We don't have to. Now, when you come in, you come by cell phone, you drive in.
Okay, welcome back, everybody. This is so difficult every year. It's very, very difficult. Before we get started, I just want to say I have a bunch of thank yous that I want to give, but the first is to all of you here in the audience and watching at home who are the parents, the teachers, the friends, the family of these young musicians. You know, it takes a village for you all to do what you do so incredibly well, and I know you appreciate all the support that you've gotten throughout your careers and the support you will continue to get as you continue on with your careers. But let's give a round of applause to all of those folks who support you. And as is my custom, I'm going to make you all wait a little bit longer before I tell you the results of the competition, because we have a number of thank yous to give for the way that this competition runs every year. It takes a village for us as well. And the first people I want to thank are the accompanists you heard today, the four pianists that played, Master Sergeant Anna Maria Matola, Staff Sergeant Christopher Schmidt, who are Marine Band pianists, and our special guest accompanists as well. Let's give them a round of applause for their performances. As good as these seven musicians are, they are still learning, preparing for their careers. And one of the aspects of this competition that we are so proud of is that as part of our educational outreach program, of course, we have professionals here in the United States Marine Band, and we offer an opportunity for each of them to get some coaching when they come to Washington to kind of put the final polished touches on their concerti before they perform. So I'd just love to give a shout out to our musicians who worked individually with these young folks yesterday. Master Gunnery Sergeant Beth Plunk on flute, Master Sergeant Doug Quincy on horn, Gunnery Sergeant Amy McCabe on trumpet, Gunnery Sergeant Trevor Mowry on oboe, Staff Sergeant Kristen Bowers on clarinet, and Staff Sergeant Matthew Gregoire on bassoon. Thank you, my colleagues. We have a marvelous staff here that helps work all of the behind-the-scenes duties that go into a project that's as significant as this. And first is Gunnery Sergeant Ellen Dooley, who's kind of our education outreach guru. She handles so many of our educational programs, and she was a huge part of this. Master Sergeant Rich Dickerson and Corporal Matias, who are on our stage crew. You saw them setting up in between all of the performances today. Staff Sergeant Chase Barron over here from our Office of Communications, taking all the photographs that you're going to get after this. Staff Sergeant Mike Dukusu and Staff Sergeant Aaron Poligian, who are back in our recording lab. They are recording and they're handling our live stream as well. Gunnery Sergeant Charles Pauls, our chief librarian, he handled all the musical needs, and Gunnery Sergeant Courtney Morton is our piccolo player, but she is also the person who arranged our reception out in the lobby for you, so thank you, Courtney. Almost there. I want to introduce you to our panel of judges. Three of the judges are directors of the United States Marine Band, myself, and my colleagues, the assistant director of the band, Lieutenant Darren Lynn. Sorry, Darren, I forgot your name for a second. First Lieutenant Darren Lynn and the associate director and executive officer of the Marine Band, Major Ryan Nowlin. Thank you, gentlemen, for your work. And every year we have a distinguished guest judge, and this year is a friend of ours from Shenandoah Conservatory down in Virginia, Dr. Tim Robley. And if you are looking still for a college to go to, Shenandoah University Conservatory is fabulous, and you should talk to Dr. Robley after the conduct. Thank you, Rob. And last but not least, just another thank you to the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation and to Major General Lukeman for all of the support that you have offered, General, to this competition. And I'm going to call you up if you, you're over here, General. I'm going to call you up and have you stand front and center, sir, if you don't mind, as we make the results. Before I announce the winners, third, second, and first place for this competition, I just want to speak to all of you and tell you how incredibly impressed we are with each and every one of you. This was one of the best competitions we have ever had, from top to bottom. You are all destined for great success, and whatever you choose to do, I selfishly hope it's music and that you stay musicians for the rest of your lives, and selfishly also hope maybe some of you will end up in the United States Marine Band someday. But you're all, yes, please. You're all wonderful musicians, and based on what I've heard from the people who have interacted with you, you're wonderful young adults as well. You should know, as you continue on with competitions and auditions and everything else you're going to face in your life, that this, when you get to the level that you're each at right now, this is very subjective. You know, the way that we evaluate people at your level, it comes down to opinion, it comes down to little details. So whatever happens at the end of today, I don't want you to feel like this is a vote of no confidence in your ability. You are all fabulous, and you are all going to be very successful. So congratulations on making it this far and everything you're going to do.
I want to thank the parents. So let's get a round of applause for the parents of all these folks here. Thanks for doing it all.
Okay, are you ready? It's like, enough, Colonel Fettig. Be quiet, please. Okay, so third place for the concerto competition for this year, winner of $500 on flute, Nika Gershman. Nika, thank you. Congratulations. Second place and the winner of $1,000 from the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation on bassoon is Nathan Shepard. The winner of the 2023 Concerto Competition for High School Musicians will win $2,500 scholarship from the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation and will return next month to perform their concerto with the United States Marine Band, with yours truly, on the podium. And I am thrilled to announce that this year's winner on oboe is Kyle Cho. Congratulations, Kyle. pictures with all of our finalists, and we have one more round of applause for these marvelous.